Truly, one of the most iconic TV science fiction props ever made is, of course, the instantly recognizable captain's chair from Star Trek the original series. William Shatner, aka Captain James T. Kirk, personified the coolness of command from the chair of the USS Enterprise. And even though several other players commanded from the chair during the course of the series, the chair itself seems to have established itself as the center of attention. An iconic story all to its own. In 2009, Starbase Columbus, a science fiction merchandiser that had been a fixture in Columbus for over 25 years, purchased a limited edition copy of the iconic Star Trek chair, licensed by CBS, sold by a British toy company, and built in China. The ad showed it as a functional conversation piece, of which only a limited number were made. It then became a centerpiece for the Starbase Columbus store for many years, with fans coming from all over just to get a picture sitting in it. But time marched on, and time was not kind to the chair. In 2016, Starbase Columbus was sold to new owners, who decided that they wanted to upgrade the chair a bit. Some OSU tech students tried their hand at it, and added some blinking lights and a couple of sound effects. But it really didn't work out so well. A few months later, on a chance meeting with the owner, I was asked if I could refurbish the chair to new and make it fully functional. Being an engineer by trade, I accepted the challenge. The chair itself was in sad shape. The left-hand lights were all the wrong color. The rocker switches were mostly broken and the wrong colors. The right-hand switch light panel was completely missing, although later found in pieces. The cradle and base were coming apart, but challenge accepted. I then spent the next 6 months researching everything I could find on the original chair as built by Desilu Studios. Blueprints, close-up photos, colors of the chair itself, the light lenses, and the switches, just to name a few. Also, the availability of reproduction parts. I then started to design out all of the electronics that I would need to make the chair fully functional and screen accurate. Also involved was knowing the full history of this iconic symbol, which all started in 1964 when it was built for the first Star Trek pilot episode called The Cage. The chair itself was built around a commercially available Madison office chair. As the story goes, that when the production crew was tasked with coming up with a command chair at the last minute for the bridge set, they grabbed one of the Madison chairs right out of the Desilu waiting room, and then built a pedestal and cradle around the chair, which also included all the lights and switches. And voila, an iconic symbol was born. This is the actual captain's chair from the series. It was salvaged along with some other set pieces, although not that many, and was recently on display up in Seattle. As you can see, the chair itself is still fairly intact, although most of the electronics have been removed and were then later discovered This is what is left of the original right-hand switch panel. It was salvaged as well and had remained in a private collection for many years, but was just recently sold to a new collector. At the time of this sale, it was then made public so that the world of Star Trek fans would know that it still existed. But enough of the original. Let us now move on with the task at hand.
This is day number one of the rebuilding of the Starbase Columbus Captain Kirk chair, which apparently was purchased about 7 or 8 years ago from a company in England. And yesterday, Bram Fulk and I brought it over to my house, so I now have it set up outside where I'm starting to go through all the problems that it has. I've started to vacuum out the inside. All of this wiring that you see will be removed. Up on top here, the left-hand panel will be completely replaced as the colors and everything are wrong. The switch panel here will be replaced as well. Wrong colors, wrong size. This panel over here on the right hand is, of course, missing. And, of course, the comm panel in the back here. This will actually be made to work. And the slot here for the data cards will also be built so that it will actually work. Some of the first things you notice is that a lot of things have been chopped up over the years, things that the people have tried to do to this that have been unsuccessful. The wood, of course, is all cracking. I mean, if you look, you can see it's all cracked. The plywood that it was made from is all delaminating. There's a really good example of it here on the side. You can see it's all split and cracked here. That's going to have to all be repaired. There's more delaminating, cracking on the sides here. That will also have to be repaired and fixed. One of the first things that we notice here, after this has now been stripped down, is the fact that this hole is too far back from the edge. I've kind of marked it here where this should be. This should be one, according to the original blueprints, this should be 1 1/4 inches. So if I put where this is going to end up being, this is one of the templates of the new, this is where it should be and where it falls out. This also then shows where this should be. This hole originally was 7 inches long. This should be 6, which is why it was always so close to the back here, and it actually should be almost 3 1/2 inches. So that will have to be adjusted. I will have to fill this in, and I will have to cut this area out here so that I can move that forward. Same thing's going to happen on the other side here, where it's a little too far back. Not as much as the other side, but it's still too far back. So when I put the new template in here, that's where that will fit. So this will have to be filled. This will have to be excavated, or cut, rather. This, on the other hand, I'm going to leave because it's close enough. And it should be all right. And here's what we completed today. We have cut and filled in for the left and right panels. So this is filled in here, and now this is the correct 1 1/4 inches from here to here. And we did that also to the bottom as well. We also cut access holes, top and bottom, so that we can get in here, because eventually I got to mount speakers in the bottom and also access to electronics and things that be down here. One other thing that I thought I would show you really quickly here is that on the back here, very bottom is the name of the company that originally built this. Built in China, of course. This was supposed to be a British company who was selling it. Okay. I don't know. This is day three, I guess. Day four, something like that. Anyway, I just wanted to show you the update here. We have finished up the gluing of both sides to put the panels where they need to be correctly. Today I finished cutting and filling in the areas for the switches, the eight rocker switches, which were incorrectly placed by the original toy company that built this and had it too far back. This should be about 3.5 inches from edge to edge according to the original blueprints. And now this is correct, and once the glue dries, we'll be good with that. I also filled in the hole in the back here where somebody had very viciously hacked a bunch of holes out to run some power cables in. Day number 10 on the Starbase Columbus Captain Kirk chair rebuild. The chair has now been completely sanded down. The areas here that needed to be filled have all been filled in, as you can see. And so it has been stripped and sanded and repaired. Remember down here we had that huge chunk that was all split, came all the way across here. That has all been filled, sanded, nice and smooth. The repairs back here, the extension has been done. In the back here, we also filled in that hole where they just kind of chopped into it with a drill bit. And I've, of course, now put in the new hole for where the fused receptacle with switch will be put. So it is ready for priming, and that will be one of our next things. This is the continuation of the Starbase Columbus Captain Kirk chair rebuild. It is now winter. Had to move inside, but I wanted to show the finished paint job on the chair. It is all finished now, and if you look, some of the things that we had before, problems like down in here, we had all those big cracks and splits, and that has all been repaired and painted, and you'd never know that that was ever a problem. The chair itself is now ready to start wiring and getting the pieces installed. Some of the things we have will be a power supply that will be in the back, and that we also will have speakers. If you look down in here, you can see in the very bottom here, I have cutouts for speakers that will be mounted down inside of there on both sides. The access panels all have little magnets in them now. And so all I have to do is just take that panel and it plops right into place. And I can just pop it out at any time, and that fills that in very nicely. So it is springtime. After 6 months, the base is now set up out in my garage. I have a nice 60-degree day. So I'm just giving you a quick overview of it. It has been, was all repaired last year. And now we're going to paint it. While the base is drying, I thought that I would tell you about the color gray that I chose for this. The actual color, I found this out, and actually the guys that did Star Trek Continues found this out. And I'm going to show you the card here. If you can see that, as soon as it focuses, if it will focus, which it probably won't. Oh, there we go. It's actually the middle one here, and it's called Gravity. And it's made by Valspar. It's a specialty paint. They have to mix it up for you. But that is the color, and that is the actual color. And it's turned out pretty good. Now that the base has been all repaired and repainted, and I have the new carpet already cut for it, and I'll be gluing that on today, but one of the things that I wanted to talk about was the hole here where the spindle from the top fits down into, which is this thing here. Unfortunately, because nobody had ever put any grease on this, and over the years it just kind of ground this down and ground it down from all the way to the big butts that have sat on it over the years. And unfortunately, what it ended up doing was the screws on the bottom here, specifically was this one and this one, ended up grinding a groove into the base of this. So obviously I had to replace these screws, which was not an easy task, but in order to build this up a bit so that this won't happen again, I went and I bought several of these what are called fender washers, and these are stainless steel, and these are the exact size as these. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to put these down inside here, and that will build it up by about a quarter of an inch, and then once I get the grease on here, we should be in business. I have gone and taped off the arms because I'm going to completely sand these down and refinish them. They're kind of in bad shape. They're scratched and worn, and some places, like in back here, it's actually turned green from mold or something. I don't know what it is. So, and it's raining outside, so I had to move into the garage. So that's where it's at, and we'll continue. This then is the big reveal on the captain's chair. As you can see, it has been fully restored. The thing that is missing here is the bottom seat cushion, which is right here. It's done. It was originally only about an inch thick, and as such, it, when you sat in it, it just went right to the board at the bottom, and so it was like sitting on a park bench. So now it's 2 inches thick. It's got some extra cushion, and it's all been redone here at the bottom, as you can see, with the Velcro, original Velcro strips and backing all restapled in. That's ready to go in, and this I used new foam so it will not deteriorate, and I went over to Joann Fabric and got myself some new fake cowhide, because the original one had had some tears in it and some paint and scratches and things. I don't know what the heck it was. The only other thing that I would note is that the arms, which have been completely refinished, I used this Minwax product here. It's called Gunstock. And that's what gave it the more correct look to it. And I'm just going to pause here and put in the cushion. And here it is, with the cushion installed. Came out good.